Ladies, gents, cocksuckers, pederists, I hope you all enjoy the show. Yes, I do.
Without him. Hey, this man was the biggest major violator in Los Angeles. I watched that cocksucker operate with impunity for over 10 years, and now I got it. The shit's chess, it ain't checkers.
Hey, everybody, good to be back with another vid for you. I have been laying back, taking everything that is going on in the world in. I have to say, it is all going for a crazy ending to the story we called life. Now, why did I show you a clip from the movie Fallen and Training Day? Well, the movie Fallen is showing you what is really controlling this world, and always has been controlling this world. And that is the wickedness in high places. The little voice that you hear in your head every day. The voice that you hear in your head is these principalities. It's patient, and it has been on this earth a long time now. Loves to throw curveballs at you. When you think you got it right, it shows you how wrong you really are. I mean, think about it. Look what everybody thought of Hillary Clinton, right? What happened? Trump wins. Curveball thrown at you. I mean, it's patient, man, and it follows what, you know, is going on around it. You know what I mean? Like, it's going to take in everything, and it's going to throw that curveball at you, and that makes you go back to the drawing board. You know what I mean? That's why, like in the clip I showed you from Training Day, he says the shit is chess, not checkers. It's all one big strategy. Time is on their side. Always remember that. Saturn is a symbol for time. You know what I mean? So that is why you see it everywhere you look. Everywhere you look, you see symbols for time. Because time is what we are in. I mean, we know that. Cradle to grave, you know, we're in time. So, you are always not going to be ahead of this thing, because this thing is, and that's why I call it a thing, because it's like we're a spirit. Like I've always been saying, video is past, we're a spirit, so is this thing. It's a spirit, but it's a spirit that's been around for a long time, and it knows us very, very well, and it is patient. And the way I have been explaining to you ever since I, like I said, I got truly saved and got sober, I start to really think critically about what was really going on with in this world. Like I said, it attacks you where your high place is. I believe your high place actually is in your brain. And that's where, you know, you'll hear, you know, a voice, let's say somebody that wants to sleep with another man's wife. That voice will be constantly attacking that person's head saying, you know, sleep with her, sleep with her, sleep with her. So that is your wickedness in high places. Also, too, it I believe, too, that it converges into our material reality world, too, where it also manifests its ways, I guess you would say, in these symbols. You know what I mean? And if you think about it, which I agree with a lot of good researchers out there, consciousness makes matter. You know what I mean? Matter did not make consciousness. Consciousness made matter. So we are conscious beings that constantly are being either led in a wrong way or a good way. I don't want to seem doom and gloom either, because that's what the checkerboard really is too. It's the yin and the yang. It's the bad and the good. You know what I mean? You can't just have all bad. You have to have some good in this world. That's why I don't like to talk about all bad, because if you talk about all bad, then you're going to go deep into that abyss. And some people can't get out of that. It's really, really, it's hard for some people to get out of, you know. I don't damn these Satanists out there. I don't damn anybody, you know, because this is what they're putting their whole stock into, this badness, you know. Hey, you want to do that? Go ahead, you know. That's your prerogative. You know, but you really are playing with fire when you do that. That's why I think when I delved into the occult and tried to study it, I wasn't trying to become a Satanist. I was trying to see what my enemy was up to. But I didn't look at the big picture. And I was doing it with a non-clear head, which is very, very, very stupid to do. I was under chemical influences, and that chemical influence is another demon in its own, and it can take you to a place where, you know, you're that's all you're thinking about, and you're under fear. You're under fear. Fear is really a big catalyst for these entities too. They want you afraid, because fear leads to a dark place. Like, I hate to bring up Star Wars, but that analogy is perfect. You know, I mean, it leads you to a dark place with hatred. Why do you think these people are rioting out in the streets? They're afraid. Like, you know, I'm not saying that all of them aren't, you know, setups, you know, because I do believe they're setup people, but I think these people that follow these setup people and these riots are afraid, truly afraid, just like it has been through history. You've seen people with fear, and they do irrational things, and that's feeding into the fear. Now, like I said, it's a chess game, man. It's a chess game, and I'd never, ever, ever, even when I was, you know, in a dark place at the time, tried to be a prophet and tell you what I think is going to happen. You know, like I said, throws you curveballs. You think you're going to get it right. You can speculate and speculate and speculate all you want, but in the end, it has all the cards. It's holding all the cards. That's what you need to understand. This is a spiritual war. It's a war of the mind, body, and soul, and it knows you very well. So, like I said, good to be talking to you guys again with the video. Sorry, it's been a while. I really want to take my time with these videos now. And as you can see, I talk a lot clearer now. I truly am on fire for, you know, our true creator God, who I believe is my father, and I pray to him every day, and I pray to him for guidance, you know, and he is the father of everything. And if you really think that, you know, something didn't create this world, then I don't know what to do for you, man. I really don't, because nothing can come from nothingness. It just can't. So, keep on guard out there, you know. Like I said, I don't want to fearmonger. I want everybody to be safe and have a happy Thanksgiving out there. And I'll probably be back again for another video around Christmas. So I'm going to leave you with this song. and a little quick clip from the song, like I always do. So enjoy. All right, God bless everybody.
God's busy.